So One UI 7 is finally rolling out to Samsung phones that aren't called the S25. And yes, it's a massive update, probably the biggest One UI refresh we've seen in a while. But let's not get too excited just yet, because if you're expecting all the flashy features that the S25 Ultra is rocking, yeah, that's not gonna happen. Samsung is once again playing the you can look but not touch game with some of the features. And there are mainly three reasons for this. First, your phone's chipset. Second, your phone's image signal processor. And third, because Samsung simply doesn't want to. So let's break down what's actually coming to your phone with One UI 7 and what's staying exclusive to the S25 Ultra. What's up guys, Sal here. And before we jump into features, here's a quick rollout timeline. If you've got a Samsung flagship launched in the last 2 years, you're lucky. You'll be getting One UI 7 sometime in April. Everyone else will start seeing the update trickle down in May and June. Alright, now onto the good stuff, camera features. One UI 7 packs a bunch of them, but not every phone gets all of them. Let's start with Audio Eraser, a super handy tool that removes annoying background noise from your videos. This feature is only rolling out to last year's flagships. Next is Auto Trim, a smart video editor that automatically cuts out the boring bits and keeps the best parts. Again, limited to last year's high-end devices. Then there's Best Face, which picks the best facial expression in group photos, so you're not stuck with that one guy blinking in every shot. The S23 lineup is also getting this feature. Now let's talk about my personal favorite, the Generative AI Photo Editing. This thing is wild. You can move stuff around, fill in missing background details, or completely change the scene right from your gallery. The S25 Ultra obviously crushes it with this feature, but surprisingly, even the S22 lineup is getting it. How well it runs on older hardware is a question mark. It all comes down to how capable your phone's AI chip is. Now, if you're hoping to record log video, sorry, only the S24 series will support that. Not a big deal, because it's a niche feature aimed at video professionals who want full control in post-production. What about slow motion recording using ultra-wide or telephoto lenses? Yep, that's another one locked to last year's flagships. Samsung's clearly decided that anything camera heavy needs newer silicon. We've also got AI filters in the mix. These lets you apply photo filters tailored to your style using on-device AI. The good news, the S22 lineup gets these features too. And finally, there are some other smaller camera upgrades here and there. But interestingly, the S21 series and anything older are completely left out. No new camera features at all. It's a harsh cutoff, but that's the line Samsung decided to draw this time. Now moving past the camera, it's not all bad news. One UI 7 brings tons of UI and usability upgrades that every eligible device will get. And honestly, they make the One UI 6 look like a half-baked beta. Animations are smoother, transitions are snappier, the whole interface feels more modern and more fun to use. Samsung also pushed almost all the main controls to the bottom of the screen, including in the camera app, so one-handed use is way easier now. They've also redesigned the notification panel. Now, I'm not 100% sold on this. Personally, I still prefer the old layout. But hey, Samsung actually gives you the option to switch back, so no harm done. Same goes to the app drawer. There's now a vertical scrolling option, but if you hate it, you can go back to horizontal. Customization is still king. Then there's the new Now bar. It's one of those things that doesn't sound impressive until you actually use it, and then you wonder why it wasn't always like this. Other cool stuff, Drawing Assist, which uses AI to help create artwork from scratch, better call recording options, improved transcription features, more battery protection settings, and just a lot of under the hood tweaks that make your phone feel fresher. And for all the foldable and tablet users out there, Samsung finally added an auto hide taskbar setting. This means when you open an app, the taskbar tucks itself away automatically, giving you the full screen real estate to enjoy. As someone who always found the persistent taskbar kind of annoying, this change is very welcome. Now, what's more surprising is that One UI 8 beta is dropping in less than a couple of months. Yes, you heard that right. And it's expected to bring at least 10 solid upgrades to the table. Click here to check out the full breakdown, and I'll see you there.